just in the quaint room, Jim.
In the quaint room, Jim.
I know I'm going now.
Oh, have you finished?
Yeah, we were just waiting for the coffee.
Are we, James?
Get yourself in.
Hi, James. Sorry, I didn't realise you were outside waiting
Give
for us.
Give yourself if you need anything.
Thank Will
you.
Do, thanks. Yeah, we're just gassing. I'm Vanessa. I don't know whether you can remember meeting me. I think on the first appointment I came with Kate. And obviously you've met Courtney before.
We met a few weeks ago. Do you remember we were upstairs? That one.
What we've got today is what's called the ADOS, it's an observational assessment. It's just going to ask you some questions, get you to do some things. All right? It's an unusual assessment, it's more unusual and strange than Courtney. Okay? So the first thing we've got is, a bit like Courtney, so I'd like you to stick some pieces on this puzzle for me. They don't fit very well because we've had to cobble it together. Let me know if you need any more. Thank you. Think it looks like anything? You can twiddle it around.
An owl.
You know. Now people say it looks like an owl or a totem pole. Arrow, rocket, do you wear your glasses all the time? You might need to take them off for this one though. What's this one? It's a story. I'll tell a story. I'm going to go first. You're going to take over and then I'll finish. Mostly pictures, there's a couple of words but not many. Okay? The story is called Tuesday. And we've got Tuesday evening around 8. The sun's setting over the lagoon. Word Turtle sat on his log, twiddling his thumbs. Suddenly, he hears a noise overhead. Startled, he looks up into the sky, where he sees hundreds of frogs flying overhead on lily pads. He's so frightened, he jumps back inside his shell. Meanwhile, the frogs carry on flying through the sky, doing loop-de-loop through telegraph poles and chasing birds. They're really having fun. Until they come to the edge of the town, where they sit and they hover, looking to see what mischief they could get up to. Your turn. say what you see. Turn the page. See what's on the other side. Do you know what to do? Start this one. Do the story. Man start having some. The frogs are flying past his window, waving at him. Come on, Wiz, they get tangled in his washing. They end up getting stuck in the sheets, knocking the poles down. But one frog's very inventive. Makes a cape out of one of the sheets. And the rest of the frogs fly in through the windows and down through the chimney pots. The hotel.
It's America.
It's America. You been to America? My guys, have you been?
New York and Florida.
I've never been. Kate, who you've met before, she's been to Boston. She stayed in Boston. And she did a journey all the way down through and went to Washington. But I think she's been to California as well. Do you enjoy America?
Yeah.
Have you been anywhere else on holiday?
Mallorca a lot as a kid.
I went to New York when I was a kid. Went to Palmer. 1973, I think, a long time ago. What did you enjoy about New York?
The weather, the beach.
Am I right in thinking, do you like the outdoor sports and things?
Yeah, I used to do a lot of mountain bike.
That's it. I was trying to remember what your mum had said you liked to do when I first met you. I wanted to say, did you canoe? Were you a canoeist? No. Just the mountain biking. Rock climbing?
Oh, yeah.
Was that proper rock climbing, or was that you just deciding to set off up the face of a cliff? I'm frightened of heights. I've always fancied doing a bit of abseiling. I don't think I'd get over the edge. Without throwing up a lift. But my bucket list is to abseil off the Humber Bridge. Do you have a job when you're not here?
No.
Have you ever had a job?
Briefly.
What did you do?
Worked in a garden centre.
Ah, that's nice. What did you enjoy it?
No.
No. Is that the only job you've had?
I worked in a hotel kitchen for the summer once.
It's quite manic, you can see in there, isn't it? Which hotel? Is it up here or...?
It was the hotel my dad ran when I was... where we lived. Great Broad.
So two difficulties. Working for family and being in a busy kitchen.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, my kids used to work for my in-laws. They used to do a guest, they had a big guest house, not a hotel, they had a guest house. So yeah, they started like you working in the kitchens and waiting on tables. Before you came to Elston House, how did you fill your time? What did you do during the day?
I was on the computer mostly.
What about now?
It's the same.
Same. You ever had problems getting along with people? Do you want me to shut the curtains?
In terms of any confrontation?
No. Are there things that other people do that might irritate or annoy you?
Just noise, mainly people slamming things.
It's quite noisy in here, isn't it? Have you ever teased and bullied?
Not really, a little bit at secondary school, but nothing major.
Why do you think you were bullied at secondary school?
Why? I don't know, I was quite passive. I guess people could kind of just do what they wanted and I didn't really react to it.
It was really quite difficult.
It wasn't. You know, constant. It was just a few incidents.
What about things that you do
ignore people a lot, I guess.
You ever tried to change it?
It depends on the mood. I'd be kind of a bit more interactive when I'm feeling better.
So did it work then? What do you like doing that makes you feel happy and cheerful?
Being on the computer and
when you're feeling happy and cheerful, how does that feel inside? Things you're afraid of. My health, mainly. What makes you frightened and anxious?
Nothing specific, it just kind of comes over me sometimes when something I've done or something. I'm just concerned that there's Lie down, usually.
What about feeling angry?
I'm gonna get angry quite a bit, yeah.
How do you think that you feel angry?
People crashing and banging.
And how does that feel inside? I don't know, I kind of shake. I don't know, just kind of isolated and can't really live like other people. An unusual one. I want you to imagine, I don't know how to clean my teeth. I want you to show me and tell me how you clean your teeth. I've got a sink, hot tap, cold tap, toothbrush, toothpaste. Show me and tell me how you clean your teeth. Show me, tell me how you clean your teeth. Designed to be unusual. Okay. What about money? Where does your money come from?
Benefits.
You take care of your own money? You pay the bills?
Here.
Here. What about when you're not here?
Hi, Mum.
Your mum? What'd you say?
I will.
You will, sorry. The phone is really distracting. Have you ever saved your money to do anything special or buy anything special with?
I did when I was younger, I'm not very good saving now.
Did you save to buy when you were younger?
A Game Boy.
Oh God. My eldest one had one. Well, both my boys had one. My mother-in-law still has one. She likes Tetris. The boys were anything from Zelda through to Mario Kart. What's your favourite game, can you remember from the Game Boy?
Yeah, I became addicted to Tetris.
Did you? It's one of those irritating games though that gets under your skin, doesn't it? Wait. Apart from Elfin House, where are you living?
I have a flat in Great Eight.
Right. Do you live on your own? Find it yourself. I'm a nosy devil, I'm
sorry. No, there's a, I'm not sure it's a charity or government that's foundation that helped me find it.
Tell me about your plan.
Ground floor, living room and a bedroom. Rural, so it's a bit harder to get a place.
Do you have to get five books and everything at the road?
There's a train station as well.
Yeah. So what do you like to do in your spare time at home? Here? Spare time?
Yeah.
What do you do?
On the computer, usually.
What about going out?
Probably go on my bike.
That mountain bike. Quite a good cycling country around. Do you have any friends? Can you tell me about them?
That's one friend I grew up with who lived near me when I was in Broughton. He works as a deck officer in the Merchant Navy.
Any other friends?
It's twins, the only friend. One works in Malawi and the other works in Bristol for a charity.
They're all dotted around, aren't they? Do you ever meet up? Stay in touch?
Two or three times a year or so.
Is that when they come back up this way? Have you ever been to visit them either in Bristol or when they've been in the UK?
No.
Do you stay in touch when? Do you use the, is it Facebook? To chat? Do you Skype?
Yeah.
Can I just get my head around Skype? I can talk to my class. What does being a friend mean to you?
Someone to converse with, talk about things you do.
What's different between a friend and someone that you work with, just work with, or you just went to school?
It's more pragmatic with well, people you work with and things, you're trying to get a specific thing done. Attracted to someone and they want to be with them for a long time.
What would be nice about it?
Someone to converse with.
What might be difficult?
Don't know, just certain things you might want to do differently.